namesake and one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Thank you for coming. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you all with us. What is that? Oh, we got a terrific crowd today. They're going to have a good time, and I hope you will, too. First off, let's meet our group of stars. Shall we do that? Out here with me, I have the ladies, and they are, first of all, Academy Award winner Patty Duke and her husband, Mr. John Astin.
How do you do?
Patty, John, it's nice to have you with us.
Thank you, John?
It's nice to be
just
back.
Just fine.
You back, huh? Ready to go?
Yeah.
Yep. Okay, next to Patty and John is Claire Mitchell and her funny man husband, Mr. Scoey Mitchell. Now, Scoey, I could have done a lot better than saying her funny man husband, couldn't I? But that's okay, it is true. You are a funny man, and it's nice to have you with us. It's your first time.
And I am her husband.
That's true. So I didn't lie. Everything I said was right down the line. Claire and Scoey, nice to have you with. And next to them.
Thank you.
There she is, ladies and gentlemen, Mitzi McCall and her husband, Charlie Brill. How you doing, gang?
Hi. We're doing terrific.
Are you?
I don't have to ask you. You look so... Oh, isn't he cute?
Oh, thank you. You're very nice. Jim, I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came too, Charlie. Anyway. Okay, first thing we're going to do is play a Tattletale quickie today. Everybody ready? I'm reaching for it. Fellas, I'm going to ask you the question. You do not give me the answer now. Just think about it. Each correct answer is worth $100 for your rooting section. Here we go. Men, since being married, do you think you've changed your wife in any way? Men, since being married, do you think you've changed your wife in any way? Don't give us any answer now. We'll come back for that in just a moment. See you later, fellas. Patty, what's John going to say? Does he feel, do you think, that he has changed you in any way?
I think he'll say yes, and I agree with him. For the better.
For the better?
Yeah, he's changed. There was a lot to change.
There was?
The man has had a hard life since we got here.
I don't know. I've always thought you were terrific.
Thank you.
He changed you, and he will say yes, he did change you.
Yeah.
All right, let's bring him on, see if he thinks so. John, what is the answer to that? Have you, in fact, changed Patty since you've been married?
Yes. I was.
That's what she said. Yeah, right. How do you think you've changed Patty, John?
Well, we have 5 kids.
You've been changing kids, but I said, how have you been changing Patty? That's a big change, isn't it?
Very big.
You're going to do very well today because somebody in your rooting section has a bird whistle. You should hear that thing. Who is that over there? It's got a bird whistle. Let's hear that bird whistle.
Oh,
wow.
Terrific.
That's terrific.
Anyway,
you've got your $100, and thank you, John.
Thanks, honey.
Thank you.
Okay, Claire, what's Scoey going to say? Has he changed you, do you think?
Don't think so.
What, is he going to say that, too?
I think he'll say if there was any change, and it was before we were married, so I don't think I've changed since.
And you don't think he's changed you at all? You were terrific then, and you're terrific now.
I'm terrific now.
That's what I think. Okay, let's bring on Scoey. Scoey, what's the answer? Do you think you've changed Claire since you've been married?
Yes. That wasn't the right answer, huh?
No, well, it might be the right answer, but it isn't the one she gave us, is the thing. You think you've changed her, huh?
Yeah, her disposition has become much more even since she's been with me. My wife is evil all the time.
That's not true. I'm sorry, Scoey. I'm sorry to hear that about that, too, but no score there. Thanks. We'll come back to you later. Missy, what's Charlie going to say? Has he changed you, think?
He definitely has changed me.
Well, now, how do they know? The front row is all saying yes, yes.
They know. We have ESP going. The thing is, I've always been very insecure. Like when a football game would get into a huddle, I used to think they were talking about me, right? And he's changed me, because now I know they're talking about me. Yeah, he's changed me.
He's changed you. Yeah. All right, let's bring on Charlie. Hey, Charlie.
Yes, yes.
What do you think? Have you changed Mitzi since you've been married?
Yes, I've changed her whole life.
That's what she said. You're right. Okay. So far, right off the bat, Claire and Scoey didn't score on that one, but Patty and John and Mitzi and Charlie each have $100 tie game right off the bat. We're going to break away for a commercial message, and we'll come back right after that. We hope you do, too.
This week in Game Show History, Spouse's Secrets debut on Tattletales. Rod Roddy becomes the voice of The Price is Right. And IBM supercomputer Watson wins $1 million, beating champ Ken Jennings on Jeopardy. Take that, Mr. Know-It-All.
Okay, we are back. This time it's story time. We're going to do one of our story questions, fellas. I'm going to ask the ladies a questions about themselves and about you guys and your lives together, and they're going to come with a clue to you in just a moment, okay? So we'll sign you off now. Goodbye, fellas.
Bye.
All right, ladies, here we go. First question, I'll only take the first response. Hands upon the table. Here we go. First question. It happened in a hotel. Claire was first. Okay, Claire, tell us about what happened in a hotel, if you will.
Okay, before I get into the story, I have to preface this. When my husband sleeps, he sleeps like he's in a coma.
Right.
Okay. They were doing, Scoey was doing the series Barefoot, and everybody had to be in New York. So
now, you mean barefoot in the park. You don't mean right. He was doing a series barefoot
right.
all the time.
He was doing barefoot in the park. So
right.
He was out here in California, and I was in New York.
Huh?
So they wanted to do the title shots. And, of course, they were going to do the title shots in Central Park. So, therefore, everybody had to come to New York. And they put them all up in the hotel plaza. So after they had been there a couple of days, Scoey got to missing me. And so he called me one night, it's about 1 o'clock in the morning, and he said, Claire, come on over. I said, but it's late. He said, come on, just put some things in a bag and throw anything on and come on over. So, okay, I get up and I got rollers in my hair and I put a hat on and I put a raincoat and dungarees. And I really look bad, but I'm just getting in a cab and I grab this little overnight bag, okay? So I get to the hotel. And I go upstairs and I knock on the door. No answer. And I knock, and I knock. I must have knocked for 15 minutes. And I said, oh my goodness, why didn't I tell him to leave the door open? So I go downstairs and I go to the switchboard and I explain my story to her. She says to me, I'm sorry, but we're not allowed to ring the rooms after 12. Go see the manager. So, as far as I'm concerned, no problem. So I see this gentleman walking toward me, and I say, he must be the manager, very distinguished looking with the tie, and he's got another gentleman with him. And I said, good evening. I says, I'm trying to get into room so-and-so, whatever the room was. And he looked at me. So he says, have you any identification? And I said, no. I says, I just came out like this. And I got shoes sticking out the bag. And I, like I said, I really look bad. And he's looking at me. He says, I am sorry, madam, but we cannot ring the room after 12. So then I say to him, but I'm Mrs. Mitchell, and I would like to get in the room. He says, I am sorry. He looks at his watch. He says, it's now 3 o'clock. He says, you are perfectly welcome to sit in the lobby and wait until morning. I said, thank you, but no thank you. I didn't come here for a sit-in. Then it dawns upon me, the way he's looking at me, he thought I was a lady of the evening.
Yes.
So therefore, I get mad and I walk away and I said, what am I going to do? I can't stay down here. I can't get upstairs. So I go back in the elevator and the operator must have seen all that was happening. So he says to me, he says, knock hard. And I said, I am. And I get off the elevator and I walk down the hall and I bang on the door hard. I think I had keys in my hand or something. And Scoey opens the door like he had been awake for the whole evening. So then I said to him, you don't know what I went through. So we're hugging and we're kissing, and the door was slightly ajar. And as we're getting ready to close the door, here comes the night manager with the hotel detective. And they said, excuse me, sir. This is a long story. Shall I finish it?
Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to welcome you to the Claire Mitchell Show.
Let me just... I gotta tell the end. Is it getting too long?
No, oh, it was adorable.
Okay, speak right up.
We're a little late, folks. We'll see you next time on...
So like I said, the door was slightly ajar. Here comes the hotel detective and the manager, and they see us. And he says, excuse me, sir, but this woman says she is your wife. She is causing a disturbance. She won't show me any identification. So Scoey says, well, this is my wife. He said, well, the room is only registered for one, and you'll have to pay for the additional person.
Oh,
Scoey said, that's all right. I don't care. The studio was paying for it. End of story.
End of story. Yes. I don't know what they're thinking back there. But I was a young man when you started that question. You know that? All right, what we need is a one- or two-word clue that somebody's going to remember.
Well, help me. I've talked so much, I've forgotten what to say.
A one- or two-word clue now, because a two-word clue's worth $50, one-word clue's worth $100. What's Scoey going to recognize?
Detective.
It happened in a hotel. It happened in a hotel. Sleep is the clue? It happened in a hotel is the question.
Sleep.
She wants to go with sleep. The yellow section's yelling, detective. Sleep. She wants to go with sleep. She knows what he'll get. All right, bring on the fellas. Shh, shh, shh. Don't talk. Shh. We must all be very quiet. Fellas, are you still there?
We're here.
Yeah.
We have a question and we have a clue. Here's the question first. It happened in a hotel. And the clue is sleep. Scoey. Tell us about that, if you will, Scoey. But try to be brief, if you don't mind.
I knew that had to be my wife. When you said sleep, and I took notice of the length of the story. I guess she was telling me about the night in New York when she was a hooker.
Yeah, that's the night. You both sure have a way with words, you know that, I'll tell you.
Oh, silver tongue.
All right, it's time for a Tattletale Quickie, everybody, and we're going to play that right now. Fellas, I'm going to ask you the question. Don't give me the answer and don't make any sound. Here it is. Men, do you like your wife to dress in a way that turns other men on? Ooh. I didn't know what that question was going to be before I got to it. Men, do you like your wife to dress in a way that turns other men on? Think about that, fellas, and we'll come back to you in just a moment, I hope. Oh, we're kidding you, Claire, but it was cute.
We had a good time.
Patty, tell us, what's John going to say about that?
That's really tough. See, sometimes, you know, if I wear something and I think it's too daring, which is even an old-fashioned word, he likes it, and I think... I'm not going to get into that, okay? he will say, yes, that he likes it if I wear something that might turn some other man on.
Okay.
As long as the man doesn't do anything about it.
Right. No, but some... Sure. Okay, let's bring on John. John, yes or no? Do you like your wife to dress in a way that turns other men on?
Well, I think she does, whether she tries to or not, you see. So, but I would say not particularly, really.
Then you lied all those times. Oh, boy.
It turns me on, honey.
Right.
I'm
okay.
Not,
be quiet.
Sorry about that, John. No score there, but thank you. Claire, how about Scoey? How's he feel about that?
To turn other men on.
Huh? Yeah, I mean, does he like you to dress in a way that turns other men on?
He likes for me to dress for him, and he is very much a man. But as far as other men, I'm going to say no and hope I'm right.
Okay. The yellow section agrees with you. Let's bring on Scoey.
Not too hardly.
Scoey.
Yes.
What is the answer to that? Do you like your wife to dress to turn other men on? Yes or no?
Well, my wife's a turn on, you know?
Yeah.
I'm very fortunate. No.
That's what she said. You're right. Thank you, Scoey. Okay, Mitzi, what's Charlie going to say?
Charlie's going to say, Charlie is so jealous. Isn't that funny? Because he's really cuter than I am, but don't tell him. He's going to say, no, he does not. And can I just tell you how I happen to know that?
Well, of course.
Because I bought this bathing suit that you could see. I mean, you really could see, right? And he said, you'll throw that bathing suit away fast. And I did.
And you did?
And I did.
Oh, okay. Let's see.
But I bought another one that was worse.
Okay, don't say anything now. Bring on Charlie. Okay, Charlie.
What?
What's the answer to that question? Do you like your wife to dress in a way that turns other men on?
No!
That's what she says about. Okay, it's halftime. And at halftime, our scores, Patty and Jan of $100, Claire and Scoey, Mitzi and Charlie are tied with $200 apiece. We will change places, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies to the rear, the gentlemen will come out here. And while we're doing that, we're going to break away for a brief commercial break. Come back and see us, will you?
Love is on the air on BUZZR, where love plays.
Okay, we're back. We're at the halfway point. As you can see, I have the gentleman out here with me now. And let's see, we've got a good close game. Anybody can win this one. But if you are in the rooting section that is backing our top winning couple, you know what we do. We add $1,000 to the total. All right. Now, ladies, it's the fellas' turn. We're going to do a story question for them, and they're going to come back to you with a clue in just a minute, okay? So enjoy the music. We'll get back to you in just a second.
Bye.
Gentlemen, are you ready to go now? You know what happens. I only take one response, so you got to be the first one up on that button. Hands upon the table. Here comes the first question. A story involving children. John. Boom, boom. Sound like the guy coming down the first baseline. Ball glove.
Okay, there are 1,000 of them, but I will pick one.
1,000 children or 1,000 stories?
Our boy, Alan, when we were married, we called Alan from the honeymoon, and Alan said, now that you're married, do you feel better?
Well, while we're all thinking about that,
what's a one-word clue for
you
that?
You want to give us a one-word clue for that, and watch it.
What's the category again?
A story involving children.
A story involving children. Honeymoon.
Okay, good clue. One-word clue worth $100 to the blue section. They're all nodding. Yes, yes. Okay, let's bring on the ladies. Ladies, we have a question. Here it is. A story involving children. And the clue is honeymoon. Patty. Tell us about it, Patty.
Oh, it was me, huh?
Yes, it was you.
Well, if it's the story I'm thinking about, we didn't have a very long honeymoon, but right after we got married, we called home and talked to our three oldest boys. For those of you out there who don't know the rest of the story, I'm not going to bother explaining it now. Anyway, we called him, and our second oldest son, Alan, got on the phone, and we told him that we were married, and he said, yeah, well, you feel better now that you're married?
That's what he said. You're absolutely right. Okay.
Good, my dear.
At this point, everybody's tied. We got a tie, three-way tie, $200 apiece. And we'll come back to find out who's going to win it all right after this commercial message for you.
How do you spell super password?
SUPERPASSWORD.
Woo! Super password tomorrow at noon on BUZZR.
Okay, we're back. We're going to play a tattletale quickie and decide this whole match here. All right, ladies, you ready to go? Here is the question. It's addressed to you. Your husband aside, of course. Would you rather get advice on important decisions from a man or a woman? Your husband aside, would you rather get advice on important decisions from a man or a woman? Think about that, ladies. We'll return in just a minute. That's a rather interesting question in light of today's men-women relations. John, how do you think Patty's going to feel about that?
I know what my wife would probably say. The sex wouldn't matter one way or the other. But since your rules say she's got to choose,
right?
I think that she would probably lean toward a man.
Okay. You say, she'll say.
I think.
Yeah. A man. Let's bring on Patty.
But what she says is up to her.
Right. We know that.
Yeah.
But you're going to say that she'll say.
That's what I'm saying now.
Right. Okay.
What I'll say later.
Let's bring on Patty. All right, Patty. What's the answer to that? For an important decision, who would you rather get advice from, a man or a woman?
Well, it's not that I think that women are any dumber than men or anything like that, but I would like to get advice from a man.
That's what John said. You are right. Thank you, Patty. Story, what's Claire going to say?
I mean, there's just no doubt in my mind whatsoever. There's just no doubt in my mind.
Well, let us in on it, then.
Right. I mean, I know there's just no doubt in my mind.
Right. Thank you, Scoy. Let's move right along now. Scoy, what's Claire going to say? Well,
that's the way you talk when you don't know.
A man. She'll say a man.
A man.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Let's bring her on and find out. Claire?
Yes?
Which is it for the important decisions, a man or a woman?
From a man.
That's what he said, and you're right. Thank you, Claire. All right, Charlie, they both got $300.
It's up to me, and I choke in the clutch. I do.
What do you think Mitzi's going to say?
Mitzi's definitely going to say a man, because she still thinks men are smarter than women.
She does, really?
Yes.
Oh, we'll get into that later.
A man, no question. She's going to say a man.
He's got to believe it.
A man.
Let's bring on Mitzi. Shh, shh, shh. Okay, Mitzi, what's the answer? For an important decision, would it be a man or a woman?
A woman, because my best girlfriends are women.
Oh, guess what Charlie said? There was only one other choice, and Charlie picked it. He said a woman. Our time is up. We have a tie game. Patty and John, Claire and Skoy are winners for today. All right, Patty and John, Claire and Skoy, you've won $300 apiece. We add $1,000 to that. Your rooting sections will divide $800 apiece. And we shall return in just a moment with more of Tattletales. Please come back with us.
It's great seeing star husbands and wives in love, but when they argue, it can be a real Valentine's Day massacre. The Tattletales Marathon continues.
Okay, we're back. We're just about out of time. I want to ask Patty and John, you've got something that everybody should watch for. Haven't you got something you guys want to do?
A play called The Marriage Gamble.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
We're going to be doing it this summer all over the East Coast and for 3 weeks in Denver.
Oh, terrific. Yeah. We'll be watching for that. The Marriage Gamble with Patty Duke and John Astin. I hope you'll be looking for that. And I hope you'll be looking for Tattletales next time when our stars will be sharing their secrets and their winnings. Bert Convy saying so long, everybody. See you next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Tattletales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.